Good evening to you, Paul.
Good evening.
Thank you so much. I know it's a bit of a cold day, it's raining, and after work, I'm assuming it's a little tiring as well. So I'm trying to keep this as short as possible. So I'm going to allow the product speaks for itself. So Ritz-Carlton Residences Colombo is a part of a larger project that's coming up in Colombo 1. I mean, I'm sure some of you know Colombo 1. This is where the current Colombo Hilton is, in that vicinity. So we call the project the One Sri Lanka Project. So before that, I thought going to the project, let me give you a little bit of details about the current situation in Sri Lanka. I'm not talking about the political situation here. I'm actually speaking about what the numbers are going to speak about. So we have estimated 4.5% GDP growth over the next 10-year term. So literally, the country will grow up to about $130-140 billion of GDP within the next 10 years or so. So that's the target. So with this, how is going to impact the real estate market? Quite simple. 6,000 luxury condos are being built right now. 6,000. This is purely within the Greater Colombo area. This is by 2020. So all of this will be available by 2020. The country is growing at 100,000 urbanized families per year. So over the next 10 years, there'll be a million or so, if you take this percentage growth, it'll come into the market. So saying that, that will create a serious demand for condominium projects, simply because Colombo, as you know, the land bank is virtually exhausted. So it's nothing but going up now in Colombo. So that's why condos is getting very popular. Even the middle income owning families are now moving into condo markets. So another factor I want to talk to you about is when it comes to real estate investment is on the middle, this one. So here, I'm talking about a little bit about the ROIs. So traditionally, our real estate markets have seen 5% on rental yields, 5 to 9% on rental yields, and again 7 to 8% on capital gains. So if you collectively look at it, this is per annum, collectively look at it, you're talking about 14-15% an annum of return in the luxury condominium products. So putting all this into perspective, what I'm trying to tell you is that condominium market is actually thriving in Colombo right now. Whether it's the mid-segment or the luxury segment, or even the public housing is now moving towards more condominium. So that's a great area that Sri Lanka is now focusing on. Then of course some infrastructure products. I'm sure you all have seen these when you look at some of the websites. If you go to the national website where we have all the products in, that is the Prime Minister's website, you will see that the LRT, that's the light rapid transport product, which is being now is being negotiated with the Japanese government, that's coming up as well. 5 lines within Colombo. It's a 15-year project. Then of course the new airport, again with the Japanese government, that we are that is an additional terminal to the existing Colombo airport, the Bandar Line International. So that will be an additional terminal coming in there. So this is all gearing up towards that golden number for tourism that we are looking at, about 4 million. So these are some of the things that I thought I'll bring to the table here. So moving on to Sri Lanka's real estate framework. So one thing I want to tell you is that in Sri Lanka, the real estate is not bought through gearing. So basically, real estate is mostly bought with the money that they earn. Banks also, the lending is quite prudent in Sri Lanka. And the breakdown, currently it's mostly owned by Sri Lankans. Not the likes of y'all, that is 27% is the expatriate Sri Lankans, but however, currently most condos are owned by Sri Lankans who are living and working in Sri Lanka, and about 8% is pure foreign ownership. So right now, 82 billion GDP, growth forecast, I talked about it, 5% annually. S&P has given us a B+ stable rating, that is for this year. And we are looking at 4.5 million tourists by 2020. And I think the number that we were looking at for this year, we have already exceeded. So I think the numbers are rising rapidly. So this in turn shows the rental returns that some of the people have seen in the condo markets as well. So these four lines represent the increases in different real estate products. So the yellow line, those who can't, but the yellow line is average price, land pricing in Sri Lanka. Whereas the red line is apartment prices, blue line is housing prices, and the green line is the land pricing. So if you look at it, it's always been an upward trajectory. We have never had a massive drop. This is always, it's growing. Sometimes it slows down, but it's always growing. So this is Sri Lanka for you. I mean, we have never seen in real estate Sri Lanka going behind. So this is something that's quite unique to us. Even though global markets fall, the real estate market, especially in Sri Lanka, has not been impacted too much. Few things here. Capital and profits, you can repatriate back to Sri Lanka. There's no tax that we charge. Foreigners are entitled to purchase now at any level of condo. 10-year residential visa facilities now being introduced. It was informed to us it will be passed at the forthcoming budget as well. Stamp duty remains at 4%, and you can freely assign any product during construction. There are no legalities. There's no tough legalities around that. Okay, so here we come for what we are here to present. Ritz-Carlton Residences Colombo. So there's very few Ritz-Carlton residences around the world, and it is actually it's fantastic to see such a product coming to Sri Lanka. We already have a Marriott in Maligama, that's a deep south. But here the Marriott Group has given us a Ritz-Carlton Residences and a hotel in Sri Lanka. So can you queue up the video?